is up, everybody? Jason here. Today we're going to take a look at an honest-to-goodness official LEGO Kinetic sculpture. This is the relatively new Hedwig set, and it's got this cool wing flapping mechanism that happens when you turn a crank at the base. And I think it's a beautiful set. I think Wes did a fantastic job designing it. And the mechanism is pretty nice. It's relatively simple, and yet it captures a basic flapping motion quite nicely. That being said, there are a couple of things about it that I'm not 100% sold on. I'm not too keen about this hyperextension of the elbow. Birds' wings don't really bend that way. The other thing is the way the wings fall down abruptly after the transition from being lifted to being lowered. It's a little bit jerky. So we're gonna see if we can do anything about that. And of course, this model is just screeching to be motorized. So we're going to add a motor into the back so that it can be run continuously. But before we jump into all that, some people have been complaining that these cranks slide off super easily, which they do on mine as well. And it's funny because I just randomly got one of these cranks from my collection, and it has a really strong connection to this axle, super strong friction. And yet these new ones slide super easily. I'm not sure what that's all about. So if this is an issue with yours, you can try and find an older crank to slide on. Or if you want to secure at least one of them, you can actually just replace the axle in the back here with an axle with a stopper on the end. Just pick whichever crank you use the most. You can just actually slide that axle with a stopper all the way through to replace the regular 5-long axle. And now at least that one crank will be held in place securely by the stopper. So onto my modifications, which are actually pretty minimal. First, we'll take off some of the decorative pieces so we can get to the mechanism. There is a crank at the base of each wing, which drives all of the movement through a pretty simple set of linkages. The upper lift arm is anchored at the shoulder, and the change in relative position between these two lift arms causes this section of the wing to tilt as the wing moves up and down. The jerkiness of the movement is a common problem in pretty much any centrally driven wing mechanism, and it's a combination of the weight of the wings being pretty far away from the anchor points, which results in a lever effect to magnify the forces acting on the mechanism, and also the backlash inherent in any LEGO gearing system. You can see that with the wings being held stationary, there's actually quite a bit of play in the crank. And the more gears you have meshed together in the system, the more backlash there is. Similarly, if I hold the crank still, there's quite a bit of play in the position of the wings. So as the wings transition from being raised to being lowered, all of the backlash in the system is taken up, and the wing essentially just free falls for a split second. I actually don't mind the wings falling fast. It kind of gives the impression that the owl is really pushing the wings down hard to gain lift. But we can dampen the movement by introducing some friction into the system. In fact, we just have to replace this regular pin at the crank with a friction pin. And conveniently, there is a friction pin located right here we can use. So I'm actually just going to swap these two pins. And we'll do the same on the other side. The wing still falls during the transition, but it's dampened a bit and falls a little bit more smoothly, which I like a little bit better. There are, of course, some side effects to doing this. The added friction does make it a little bit harder to turn the crank, and that friction pin will wear a bit over time. As far as the bend in the elbow goes, there is a really easy change we can make. We can just shorten this linkage between the upper and lower lift arms. And we just need to replace the full bushing between these two connectors with a half bushing. Conveniently, you usually get an extra one of these half bushings in any sets that have them. So you should get one from this set, and maybe you have another one floating around in your extra parts pile. As a result, the wings stay straight on the downward stroke and they actually bend a little bit more on the upstroke. And it's a pretty subtle change, but personally, I prefer it. And the last thing we're going to do is motorize the model. I designed this motor assembly, and it's a pretty simple 9-to-1 gear reducer that can just slot into the back. And you might be able to figure out how it's built just by looking at it, but if not, I have created a parts list and instructions, which you can find over on my website. So we just need to remove the hand crank assembly. And the axle as well. And this actually needs to be assembled in a pretty particular order. First, we will actually get this short lift arm from the hand crank assembly and slot it into the top of the motor assembly. Then we'll remove this connector and stick it into the base axle hole here. Then we should just be able to slot the motor assembly up into the back. You may have to adjust the position of the wings to make sure that the axle from the motor aligns with that axle connector. And it's pretty much hidden in the back under the tail, which is quite nice. It's a little bit out of the way. And that's about it for this video. I certainly hope LEGO will make more of this style of set in the future. As always, thanks for watching, keep on building, and I'll see you in the next one.